Hello guys, how are we doing today? Welcome back to our channel and welcome to this video. I don't believe you're doing good, I don't believe you're doing great. In this video, we're going to be doing an analysis of USDJPY and what to expect from the market this week. In case you're just coming across our videos, in case you're just coming across our channel, I want to say welcome, it's good to have you. What you want to do right now is click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell because we release videos like this almost every day, letting our viewers know what to expect from the market per time, and you don't want to miss out on any of such videos. Before we get into the business of this video, I want to say congratulations to those who were able to take the trade based on our last analysis of USDJPY. When we did that analysis, the market was here. You can remember this healthy bullish candle, this bullish engulfing bar. We did say that the market will be going bullish, and you can see Monday the market bought a bit, Tuesday the market sold, and Wednesday the market ended as a pin bar. Thursday it bought, and on Friday it ended as a doji. So we expected the market, we said that the market will buy. Of course, remember the weekly time frame, the market ended as a doji. So we did say there was some level of indecision in the market. And we can see the two dojis had long lower wicks. So we said there was strong bullish pressure, which was the reason why we said USDJPY is likely to buy. But we would like to see how the market will present. If we see a bearish rejection and it closed below the 10-day simple moving average, then we'll consider a sell. And if we see a bullish pressure, then we'll consider a buy. But we did say that the bullish move was more likely. Of course, another reason was because fundamentally USDJPY was weak. If you watched last video, you remember I made a statement like that. That fundamentally USDJPY was weak, and we see the possibility of it buying more. Now let's start our analysis on the monthly time frame. On the monthly time frame, you can see USDJPY bought up to this region, made the all-time high here, then started selling. It sold down to this support region, and we had bullish rejection, and it has been buying ever since then till it retested the all-time high again, and we had a bearish engulfing bar here. Then the next candle was a healthy bearish candle. So down here, the next candle was a bullish candle, which was the month of January, and the market bought up to this region. It came slightly above the open of the last week, which was the last month candle, which was a healthy bearish candle. Of course, if you've been following our channel, remember that we did say when it started buying, we considered this a retracement and we expected it to end somewhere here. But as you can see, the market exceeded that region and altered that particular analysis. So this is the month of February. We've had only one complete trading week pass, and it is currently a bullish candle. So we're not going to be conclusive about that. There are still 3 more weeks to go. Now let's consider the weekly time frame. On the weekly time frame, we can see after the market bought from here up to this region, retesting the all-time high again, we had it make a tweezer top, which is a bearish reversal candlestick pattern, and we took a sell. The market sold down to this region, then we saw bullish rejection and we considered a buy, which it bought up to this region. This was where we expected the bullish move to end. When we considered it a retracement, it got here, we saw bearish rejection only for subsequent week to be bullish, and it bought up to this region. So after the market got to this region, the next candle was a doji, and you can see it has a long lower wick. Next candle, which was 2 weeks ago, was also a doji, and you can see it has a long lower wick. So each time the market sell and come in contact with the 10-day simple moving average, we see strong bullish rejection. Then last week the market ended as a bullish candle. Now let's consider the daily time frame. On the daily time frame, you can see the market sold from here down to this region. Then we saw bullish rejection. We had a bullish reversal candlestick pattern here, and it bought up to this region. It made intention to sell and continued buying again till this region, and we saw bearish rejection again, only for the bulls to come in strongly and pushed it up. Then the last candlestick last week was a doji. The candle before that was a bullish candle. Now let's consider the 4 hours time frame. on the 4 hours time frame, we can see the market sold down to this region. Then we saw strong bullish pressure. It pushed up to this region and it ranged here a bit, only to sell again, and the bulls came in and pushed it up. So that's what happened in the market last week. What do we expect from the market this week? Pay attention and look at the chart critically. Firstly, on the 4 hours time frame, we can see here that the candlesticks here are little bearish candles, and they are showing bearish intention. They are showing that the bears are coming into the market. Also, look at the RSI here. It had gotten to the overbought region, and we said every time the market gets to the overbought region, she start considering a sell. Now, the last candlestick on the 4 hours time frame is a small bearish candle. This is point number one. Now, look at the chart. Look at this region. Let me compress the screen a bit. Take a look at this region of the chart. If you are looking at it critically, you see that the market has made an inverted head and shoulder pattern here, which is a bullish reversal chart pattern. Now take a good look at this. We can call this first shoulder, call this another shoulder, and we can call this the head. You can see that now, which is a bullish reversal chart pattern. Then coming to the daily time frame, we can see here that we have a strong bullish pressure after this. So the market bought from here quite significantly up to this region. We had a little bearish move only for the bulls to come in and push it strongly back to this region. Then the next candle is a bearish candle. You can see that. So the daily time frame is showing us that the bulls are in the market, even though the last candlestick is showing indecision. Now follow me. Then look at the weekly time frame. On the weekly time frame, we can see the market started buying from here. It got to this region, we saw bearish rejection, only for the bulls to come in and push it up to this region, which is the next resistance region. We had a 10-day simple moving average crossover the candlestick here. Then we had bearish rejection. The next candle, we also had the market sell only for the bulls to push it back up, and the next candle is a bullish candle. So we can safely say that the bulls are strongly in the market right now, and we should expect the market to buy. So on the 4 hours time frame, we can see bearish intention, no doubt. But what I will suggest is that we observe the market and let it make a bullish reversal candlestick pattern, either on the 4 hours time frame or on the daily time frame. So there is possibility that the same thing that occurred here is likely to occur here, but we'd like to see a clear bullish reversal candlestick pattern on the 4 hours time frame before we take a buy. And I see the possibility of this region being broken, no doubt, because of how the weekly time frame has appeared. And this region, of course, we said we've seen, okay, also looking at the chart here, you can see it is more like the inverted head and shoulder. So I see the possibility of the market coming back to this previous all-time high. Maybe it will exceed, but for now, let's say this is our next target, which is 151.7. So that's what we're expecting from the market this week. If you have a different opinion, you can use the comment section. If you have any question, you can also use the comment section, and we'll be glad to have a conversation with you. Like we always say, trading is a highly risky endeavor. You don't venture into trading without proper knowledge. If you know you don't have sufficient knowledge about trading, you don't want to take this trade, you can watch this video for educational purpose, and it's going to serve you better than risking your heart and money in something you don't fully understand. If you want to get our Forex course, which is a complete guide on how to trade the financial market, it has 30 videos and 3 ebooks, including my book Trading Without Tears. I strongly recommend this course for anybody who is just starting out in the Forex space or someone who is yet to find his way around the financial market. So if you want to get our Forex course, check the description of this video. You're going to see the link where you can get our Forex course. And if you want to subscribe for our Signal service, where we'll give proper entry, stop loss, and take profit, check the description on this video. You're going to see a link where you can subscribe for our signal service. And if you want to get a copy of my book, Trading Without Tears, check the description on this video. You're going to see a link where you can get the soft copy. If you want the hard copy, send us a direct message to any of our social media handles. You can find our social media handles in the description of this video. Tell us your location. We'll tell you the cost of shipping it. Once your payment is confirmed, you'll have the book delivered to you. So that's it from us on this video. I hope you got value. See you in the next video. Bye for now.